purely the seller's discretion. Even after, even if you had agreed for a rebate, after 8 months, like if you feel like if there is a follow up, then the seller can hold the rebate. So even though it is a discount, but it is not the one that is, this discount is not given directly at the sales order itself. And it is realized only at the billing stage, and it is settled after the invoicing has been done. Okay, this is the rebate. And in real time scenarios, we have so many rebates. Mailer rebate is very famous there, I believe. Okay. So it means like after you have purchased it, you send the coupon or something form filled. I think you will be getting some money as cash back or refund. Okay. But in SAP, it happens like you agree for something called as rebate rate or called as approval. Okay. When we say approve in a normal English, it means like it is accumulating or gathering something over a period of time. Okay. Here also the approval stays the same thing. You are entitled and you are gathering some discount in your account for over a period of time. And how it has been being settled is something that is being agreed between you and the seller. Sometimes it can be settled on ad hoc basis. It means like whenever the customer wants, he can be settled, or it can be done on monthly basis or quarter basis or at the end of the rebate. So this is the one thing. And here the settlement is always carried out by the credit memo. And there are some activities in the rebate that is done out of the system. For example, okay, whatever you are buying, so you are getting a rebate for that. Okay, that is fine because you are having a sales order, you are having a billing document for that. So you are doing that. Okay. Whereas sometimes like your customer or your representative, he carries out or he helps you with the promotional activities like helping you to display your product prominently in any product fair or in any supermarket, or carrying out any promotional campaign on behalf of you. So these are the things that are helpful for your business, but they are not captured in the business activity or sales document. Okay. In such cases, you might want to reward your customer by adding something in his rebate account. Okay. So this is called as manual payment. And rebates are something we normally define over a period of time. So for example, that can start from this year to the next year, to the end of this year. Sometimes you can even decide on the validity, whether it should start from today and extend to one year from today or something. So these dates are confirmed by configured by your rebate type settings. Okay, so let us go to the SPRO first. At the end of the day, rebate is just under condition type. Okay. So what happens is you must have all those condition types in your pricing procedure when you are creating a rebate. Okay. So that is the only way you can carry out a rebate in your sales process. Okay. So that is why if you could see the standard pricing procedure, you could see almost 100 condition types. But if you go to the analysis part of your sales order, you could see your PR00, your MWST, your cash discount, or any discounts, customer discounts or material discounts that are given at this period of time. So, which means the system will take only those condition types for which the condition records are found at that moment. Okay. So let us go to the sales and distribution. Rebate comes under the billing. So go to billing. rebate plus the rebate agreement. So in SAP, we must have noticed that whatever we do, first we have some type of those activities. Sales document types, delivery document types, building documents, and similarly we have the agreement types. So let's go to the agreement types. I mean, what are the ways you can give rebates, or what are the things you can give rebates for? Katie? Okay. Okay, you mean to say like any electronics or any particular group? Yeah, that's what I'm asking. That's what I'm asking. What are the things you can defend rebates for? Material group you can do. Whomever buys any electronics, they will be getting some rebates. And it happens like we can give it for customer group, as usual you can give it for individual customers, individual materials, as well as the material groups, as well as the customer groups. For example, you can say whomever buys electronic, they will be getting the rebates. You can say, if this customer buys so and so goods, then I can give him rebate. Okay. Those kind of things are there. So you could see something called as material group. So one second, I will show you one NM02. Sales organization data. You have something called as rebate group. Volume rebate group. Okay. For example, this is useful when you are using the material group concept. As you might want even to select for only certain products within the electronics, for example. Okay. You might want to give only for hair dryers, or within the hair dryers you might want to give for only certain brands for which you want to give promotion for. In such cases you have to choose the volume rebate group. Okay. You can define this many more entries for this. Okay. So you can enter the volume rebate group entry here. And you can select the materials that have these entries only. These are. So let us go to SPRO. So let us start with one simple customer hierarchy. Customer rebate, as well as we will see one material rebate. So let me select that group. First, start with your date configuration. So whenever you start a rebate, the system will automatically propose the date. Okay. So it could be either the start of this year, or starting from today, or starting from this month or this week. Okay. So that is defined from here. Okay. From where it has to be started from. Okay. If you leave it as no proposal, you can no proposal, or leave it blank. Okay. That will start you. That will help you in giving today's date. Start with today's date. Next one is the valid 2. Okay. Then default payment method is like how this customer is, this rebate is being settled with. Okay. With through what kind of documents. Okay. Whether it is through bank credit or check. Then this status is the rebate status. So whenever we are creating, so not only the rebate, even with the condition record we supply. So whenever you are creating Either it has to be go started at the release status or open status, or sometimes whether it should be started with a blocked status so that somebody reviews it and then approves and releases it. Okay, so this is the default status when you want to create a release. So let me see. It's in the open state. Then you have the condition type group. Do you remember where we have used the condition type group previously? In one of our previous scenarios, we had seen this condition type groups. Where? No. In pricing related scenario, we have seen that. We group everything and assign that group to any one particular parameter. We had seen it in the sales deal. Yeah, I mean, at the end of the day, condition type comes under this condition technique. Okay. We had done it in the sales deal. And we had done it in the condition exclusion. So you had grouped certain conditions together and grouped another set of conditions together, and you had made it as group A versus group B. So which one is most favorable that has to be applied, or which one is least favorable that has to be applied. So those kind of things. Practice. Okay. So here also we are going to use the same condition type group, which means you are going to group certain condition types which are relevant for rebate, and you are going to assign that particular group to your rebate agreement. So since that assignment is done outside, here you can see a grayed out entry. Then is the verification level. Okay. So when you are creating a rebate and when you have made some approvals, okay, and which one you want to, and you want to go and see what are all the documents that have that has helped you or that has made this approval possible, okay, to see that you can see either through the all the documents are displayed as totals individually by the sole to party or sole to party with the material combination or something. Next one is a different validity period. Okay. By default, the system has the system, the rebate and the condition types associated with it has the same validity. Okay. But for some reasons, you might want to give the validity of the condition records different from your rebate. For example, your rebate may be running for the whole year, but you want to give a special rebate on stationaries only between the month of May to July. Okay, that is the school period. Or sometimes you might want to give a special rebate only for this Christmas or New Year period. Okay. Your condition group may have, let me say, four or five condition types. Okay. Out of which, for only one condition type, you might want to give a different validity. In such cases, you just can choose the different validity period. Okay. Then is a manual approval. This is what the scenario I told, like, when your customer does something out of SAP and you are happy and you want to reward that customer, then you can manually pay the customer, manually add some amount in the customer's approval. Okay. If you want to do that, if you feel that that is a part of your business process, then you have to enable the manual approval and you have to give the appropriate document type based on which you are going to post. By default, it is R4. Then is the agreement calendar. This agreement calendar says for which period you have agreed for, which factory calendar or which the working calendar for which you have to choose for this particular customer. Then is the manual payment, whether you can allow the manual payment for this particular rebate. So what happens is sometimes your customer you have agreed a rebate, you have entered into a rebate agreement with your customer, and you can see that he is doing well, and he is matching up or meeting up the trend available. For example, like you expect that he will do out of, okay, you upgrade for a 12,000, you expect that he will be getting a $12,000 accrual per year. Okay. As like that, he is getting approximately $1,000 every month, okay. Right now we are in the seventh month, okay. Suddenly customer is saying like, hey, like I am expanding my business, so I'm in shortage of money. Can you please give me some money from my accrual? Okay. At the time you go for a ad hoc accrual, which means like you need not wait for monthly run or quarterly run. You can create a rebate settlement at that period. Okay. So when you are running a rebate settlement at that period, how much you can give to the customer? I mean, we know that the rebates are carried out for the invoices, which means rebates are carried out for the amount which the customer has paid for. Okay. But here you can say that how much you can give, whether you can give only for the amount that has been invoiced or whether you can give for the pro forma invoice. So we have seen what a pro forma invoice. Pro forma invoice is like the replication of an actual invoice, but that is not an actual invoice. Which means in this case, the customer has received the good, okay, but he has not been invoiced yet. Maybe like it will take next 15 days according to the payment period. It will be next 15 days it will take to invoice him. So meanwhile, you can run your pro forma invoice and you can give whatever rebate he is accrued based on the pro forma invoice. Or sometimes you might even want to give an unlimited or out of the rebate range. For example, in this case, I can say that he wants around $10,000. I am in the 7,000. Right now he has accrued 7,000 and we are in the month of June. So you know that by October he will accrue that or attain that 10,000 range. Okay. So you might want to help him and you want to give $10,000 as the settlement for rebate settlement even though he hadn't come up to the 10,000. Okay. So that assignment, So that one is being given here. If you don't want to give any manual payment, you might want to do only the rebate settlement runs to be processed. Okay, that is, in such case you have to leave it blank. One is the payment up to accrual value, up to the invoice or performance settlement, and C1 is the unlimited for manual payment. Then comes your okay, then the partial settlement. Okay, so sometimes like you might want to give your customer the settlement, but not the full one. You might want to give it in partial amount. So in that case, I'll say partial amount, and you might want to, based on your business, you might want to even reverse the accruals. For example, you might have given the sum with. Some rebate settlement for him, but after that you realize that you had created out of mistake or something, so you have to go for reversal of accrual. If you want to do that, you can enable the reverse of accrual. Then is the settlement period, whether it has to be monthly or which one you have to follow, monthly or quarterly or annual basis. Then is the settlement. When you are finally settling the rebate, so what is the document type you have to use? So that is the settlement. And if you have made any mistakes while creating or while running the rebate settlement, you might want to go for correction. So in case of correction, which document type you have to use? So that is defined here. And next is the minimum status. I mean, this is the status you must have reached, make the status of the rebate agreement so that you can go for settlement. For example, you cannot settle a rebate when it is in the open status, or you cannot accrue a rebate when it is in the closed status. Okay. So you have to say like, I have released this agreement for settlement, or opening the settlement itself, you can find out like a settlement has been created but not yet paid. Okay, so these are only status. So when you want to create for settlement, what must be the minimum status? So by default it is the B. Okay, so this is the agreement type. This is the configuration for your rebate agreement type. Let us go to the another agreement, material agreement or something. Okay. Order type for manual agreement. Sorry. In group rebate, it starts with the first day of the week and the end of the month. Okay, and here there is no change. They didn't allow for any manual approvals. There is no manual settlement. It has to be, everything has to be done only through the final settlement. Just like how you differentiated your business process with the document type, here also you have to differentiate your rebate requirements with the these parameters. Okay. So let us do one thing, let us copy this material rebate and we'll do it for ourselves. Okay. DAPS. So we want this rebate to be, material rebate to be starting in the first of this month, and it must be valid up to no proposal. Okay, I might want to go with a separate date, mid of next month or something like that. Okay, then I am using the condition type group 2. Okay, so that I have to make the changes outside. Okay, okay, I want to give the manual accruals for my customer. Okay, then I want to allow to the pro forma invoice, or I might want to go for no limit for the manual payment. Okay. Then, okay, partial payments I want to do. Okay. These are the other things. Okay, so let me just so now we had defined the agreement type. So I was talking about the condition groups we are using. Okay. So let us go to the condition type group. So we have let us define a condition type group 002. Okay. So when you are creating a condition type group, so you have to give the category. For example, we had seen when we are creating the sales deals, we had seen that we have to mark it is relevant for sales deals or promotions or rebates. Okay. So now let us copy 002 and make it as ZAPS. Okay, so let me save it. Had you just created your own pricing procedure? Anybody? Your own condition types? Anything related with rebates? Okay, then we'll do one thing. So we'll use the existing this one itself. Condition type group is okay. So let me do one thing. New entry ZAPS. Okay. Here also you can see the counter. Well, like if you are using more than one condition type, how it has to be. So I want one material rebate. Now I think so we can copy the existing one. Copy it. So our condition type is VAPS. There is a table number here. You can notice. You have entered the condition type. So if your condition type has we have seen that there is something called as key combination. Okay. So whenever you enter KR00, because that is the one we use most, okay. You enter KR00 and press enter, after clicking confirmation button, you'll get a pop-up saying that this many possible entries are there. Okay. Similarly, here also we are using the condition type. So obviously, condition type is going to have a access with more than one condition table. Okay. If there are more than one condition table, then you might want to use only one combination for your rebate. So in such cases, you have to mention what is the number you have to say use. Okay. In this rebate, somebody has created TTM. Okay. Can you see there are four entries with the same condition type? The same condition type is there, but they are using four condition tables for that particular condition type. Okay, so they have mentioned everything. If I don't want to use the table 523, I'm using this GCBO as my rebate condition type. Let me say, like, I don't want to go for campaign ID and metal group 1. So I can remove this table number 523 alone in my rebate. Even though I can find that entry I can create entry for that in my condition record, but when it comes to rebate, that is going to be get excluded. Okay. So you can decide what are all the tables you might want to use or not. Okay. Let me save this. Okay. Fine. And then now I have created a group. I have assigned the condition types to that group. Now I have to assign that group to my rebate agreement. Okay. So what is our rebate agreement? ZAPS. Okay. So overwrite it with ZAPS. Okay. So now we have our own rebate agreement. Now if I go into the rebate agreement and see, I could see instead of condition type group 002, we have been assigned with ZAPS. You can see that we have assigned with the group ZAPS. Okay. So this is the rebate type configuration. Okay. Once you have created a rebate, okay, it is going to get settled and it will be determining a account determination. Okay. We will see that account determination once we create the settlement document. Okay. Now we have created a rebate agreement. Okay, we have made those configurations. Now we have to tell the system who are all relevant for rebate, which means like which billing documents are relevant for rebate. Because we see that the rebates are calculated based on your invoices, not on the sales orders. So you have to activate the rebate for the billing documents as well as the sales organization. So our standard billing or invoice type is F2. Okay, F2 is relevant for rebate. If I uncheck this, so even though the customer had made so many purchases using the financial document type F2, he won't be having any rebate accruals, because if I uncheck this F2, that is relevant for rebate, then I won't be getting any rebates based on that. Okay. Similarly, I have to activate the rebate processing for organizations. Okay. So whatever sale that is made through the sales organization 1000, that must be entitled for rebate. Okay. And third one is in the customer master. So let me go to VD02. Let me choose a customer, T-1-10-00. In the sales area data billing tab, I must have enabled that this customer is relevant for rebate. Okay. If I don't enable a customer for rebate, okay, after making any sales order, like if I, even after making several sales orders, you can create any accruals for this particular customer, because he had marked that this customer is not relevant for rebate. Similarly, there is something called as price determination here, you can see. So when this customer is a part of any customer hierarchy, okay, so which means like the price you are setting at the head office level, that will be automatically percolated to the lower level. if you want to do that, to use that functionality, then you have to check the price determination functionality. So these are all the prerequisites for carrying out a rebate agreement. Okay. So now let us go to the execution of rebate agreements in the ECXS. Logistics, sales and distribution, master data, agreements, rebate agreement, create VBO1, O is the alphabet O, VBO1. So what we have created now, VAPS. Here I am saying which customer is going to get the rebate. So T-62A10. Okay, let me give the external description. This external description is the description that flows to the point of sale system. Sometimes if your customer or your franchise store doesn't have the SAP, instead now the data are flowing from your SAP to the legacy system. In such cases, if you have any condition types, if you want to send any condition types that are having the that are relevant for rebates, then it will carry this external description also. Okay. The rebate. Okay. And I am proposing the validity period. Let me say it starts from today 26082011 up to 31122011. I go to the conditions. This is for a material related rebate. So for this particular customer, I am saying if the customer buys this material, I can give the discount. So you can see there is two items. One is amount and one is accrual. By default, the system automatically copies the amount entered here as the rate of accruals. The amount and accruals must be the same for carrying out the rebate activity, rebate accrual calculation. So let me say 5%. Okay, this is for €5 per piece. Okay. So here there is no scales, and the both this amount value as well as the accrual value must be the same. Even SAP acknowledges that way. It says like only when the both are same, the system can calculate. And another thing is like you cannot go for a scale based rebate. For example, like I can give 5% of accrual until $100,000 of purchases. If you process $1,000, then you might want to give for 2% extra, that is 7% or 8%. That kind of scale value is not possible. However, you can set the starting or base range from which the rebate accrual starts. In some cases, the rebate can start from the direct, the first sale or first dollar of your purchase. Sometimes you might want to say like, only if you cross the 10,000 mark, you will be entitled for your rebate. So you can set that kind of scale value, but you cannot have a different accrual value. Okay, so let me save this. This customer can get €5 per piece as the rebate accrual. Let me, let us be still more generous. Insert 25 pieces. So I'm saving it. Here there are something called as one is the settlement material. So here in this case we are creating a rebate for a material directly. So we don't need a settlement material. But in some cases you create a rebate for customer, which means whatever this customer buys, he will be getting a rebate. Okay. So there the rebate is not material specific. But to create any sales document, what are the things you need? Can somebody say? To create any sales document, if you say a sales order, or even if you remember what is there in a billing document, it is fine. What are the things you need? Okay, sold to party is what we need. Okay, fine. Material and quantity. Okay, without material you cannot create any sales document. Okay. Similarly, yeah. You must have a material. Even if it is zero quantity, you must have a material. Okay. So even here in this case, your rebate accruals, I mean your settlement documents are nothing but your sales document. It always creates the settlement request. This like your credit memo request, debit memo request, your rebate settlement request is also going to be a sales document which has to be billed at a later time. Only when you build that request, it becomes a finance document. Okay. So, to create any sales document, you need a material. In this case, it is fine because you are defining the rebates for particular material. So, when you are creating a rebate settlement, the system will say for this particular material, so and so pieces, I am giving this much amount. Okay. But in case of material, not specific rebate, which means the customer specific rebate, or sometimes even the group of materials, okay, whatever the customer buys for electronics or something. In such cases, we define something called as settlement materials. Okay. Settlement materials are nothing but a dummy material which can be used which can be used to create the settlement requests in your sales document. That is the only purpose. So even though you are using you give a regularly using article or existing article, that won't make any difference in your sales process. Okay. So we have set the conditions for this particular customer and material. Okay. Let us save this. Okay. Material rebate 97 is created. So let us make a sales order or go through a sales cycle. / NVA 01 OR recipient was 10. Let me say 100 quantities. How much the customer must get? For 100 pieces, you must get 2500 euros as the rebate accrual. So, if I go to the sales document, okay, I don't see any rebates here. Okay. Even though I can see there is something called as rebate basis, I don't see any rebate related condition types. Because, let me go to the pricing procedure here. Basic function, pricing control, define and assign pricing procedures, maintain pricing procedures. Our standard is RVAA01. I select that. Whether it is a sales deal or promotion or any discounts, whatever you want, the benefit you want to pass to the customer, it has to be present in the pricing procedure. Only then it will be flowing. But we are talking something about the requirements. You remember requirements and the calculation types. Okay. So this block 901 to 906 is the rebate thing. Can you see there is a requirement number 25 set for that? Requirement number 24. Requirement number 24 says that it will be only in the billing document. Since you had set it for 24, that is only in the billing document, the system will take. It will show only in your billing document, not in your sales order, normal sales order. There is one more still specific, that is only in the rebate relevant billing documents, that is number 25. Okay. So, since you had given the requirement 24 for this particular condition type, the system doesn't show any of your rebate basis, I mean rebate benefit in your sales order. Okay. So, let me, so if I save and invoice the sales order properly, then I will be getting a rebate accrual of 2500 euros. So I have saved it. Now I have to deliver it to 101 yen. 2200 0505 0509. Go to subsequent functions. Okay, create the transfer order, generate two items, save it. Do the PGA, machine 02N. Now I have delivered it, I have done the PG also. Now I go for billing creation. Okay. Now I select here and go to the conditions. What happened? 204. Go to the analysis. What is our missing DO? 02. Condition record is missing. There is 2. Once again, let us see why it hasn't so. Flash O, VB, O, 3. Okay, we're going to display more itself. 97. Okay, as usual. Condition. BO02. Customer and material. Okay. The customer is 612. Fine. 26.8. What could be the service rendered date is 26. Okay, so we have maintained that only. A 6 to A 10 is the customer and A01 is the ETL. Oh, sorry, the document date is on 25. Okay, that is the reason. Because our validity starts from, no, but that is, even the billing date is 26 only. This is the one thing, let us change this. Okay, let us save this. Because let us change the validity of the condition record. Let me go to the display rebate to change mode. Okay, 97. Okay. Conditions. Let me say 01 1 2001. Hey, the material is A01, but we are using the material 101 in our business process. Okay, 25. Okay, what happened is also living in this here. So there is something called as retroactive rebate. Okay, you have entered into a rebate agreement with your customer today, but having the validity from start of this year. Okay, which means like you took a while to assess your customer and how he pays regularly or how much of volume of business he gives. So you took a while to assess your customer, and after you are satisfied, then you are ready to go get into rebate agreement with your customer. Okay, today I am entering a rebate agreement with my customer. Let me say that I have created a document 97 just now. Okay, so after creating any document, so whatever sales transaction I carry for that customer, okay, it will automatically accrue the rebate accrual. Okay, that is 80 101 100 pieces. Okay. But when you are settling, you remember, so here there is no debate related thing. Okay. So when you are settling, your customer will say like, see, even though we have created the debate agreement now only, but we have been collaborating and we have been working for past 1 year, okay. So I want the benefits for my past sales orders also. Okay. So which means you want the rebates to be active in the retro period. Okay. So that is the retroactive rebate. Okay. So you start the validity of the rebate in your past. So which means your rebate has to be the validity date of your rebate is set to the start of this year or start of this month. So that is once you have created the billing, when you are creating the rebate accruals, you have to update your rebate accruals by calculating the or by considering the past documents which has been created before this sales agreement was created. Okay, so that is the concept of retroactive rebate. /NVN02N. So /NVF01. Okay, now it must be there. D002. Okay, that is a material rebate. So this material rebate was not present in your sales order, but it came in your billing document. When I save this, I will be getting the weight thing. Okay, so now I go to /NVB02. 97. So this is the error which you normally get. The volume, sales volume for the agreement is not correct, which means there have been sales orders that was created before this agreement was created, but that lies within your rebate agreement's validity. Okay. So to update that, we have a separate transaction. If I go inside now, since the sales volume is not updated, I go to rebate payments or sales volume. Okay. Here only I can see how much has been accrued. So it will say that nothing has been accrued. So I have to update the billing documents for my rebate. Okay, so I go to logistics, sales and distribution, billing, rebate, okay. Update billing documents. What is my rebate number? It is 97. Okay. I uncheck the test so that the system automatically calculates all the rebates. Okay, the system finds that there is a billing document that is 36157 that was created before this rebate agreement was created, but the validity lies within that rebate period agreement. Okay, so it copies this value. So previously it was 2500, now we will need another sales order for 2000. I mean, this must be another 2500. So our rebate must be accrued with the rebate accrual of 5000 euros. So slash n VBO2 97 rebate payment sales volume. See, the system has accrued the values, both the past as well as the current one, into 5000 euros. Now let us go for the manual accrual. I say like, okay, I am very happy with what he has proceeded. Okay. So I want to give some more money to him as the rebate accrual. So let me add $1,000 euros for one material and 500 euros for another material. Okay. Then you open accrual. Okay, for this reason we hadn't made any rebate. I mean, system hadn't approved any rebate, so it is not taking it up. So let me save this. Now for the customer, along with the 5000, you have added 1000 more, which means his accrual values has raised to 6000 now. I have just created a request. Now I have to bill it so that it can be accrued in his account. So I'm going to, okay, why I came to VA02, because sometimes there will be a billing block. Okay, so here there is no billing block. I can bill this rebate request directly. Okay, so bill it. Okay. Here it shows it is a zero page. This is the use of settlement material. Here there will be some material, okay, some dummy material. I go into the conditions, I can find that 1000 which I had added now. I save it. So come to slash and VB 4297 rebate payment sales volume. Oh, sorry, that is okay. I did a mistake. The accruals must be added as minus, so minus 2000. Slash NVF01. Okay, fine. Now let me come to VBO2. Rebate payment sales volume. Okay, 6000 is there. Okay, now let me say that at the end of the, okay, now meanwhile let us say one partial settlement. The customer in the middle of the rebate period, he asks like, I want some money. I go to pay for this material. I am saying, okay, you have got 6000, out of which I will give you 3000. Okay. So save it. As usual, the system creates a partial settlement rebate request. Okay. Requests are always the sales document. So I go to sales document and I check it. Okay, everything is fine. I am releasing it for billing. Okay. So that it can be billed. Okay. Now I bill it VS01. Okay. I have done a partial settlement. Within the rebate, I can see what are all the documents that are related with that particular rebate. Whether it could be the rebate, go to rebate payment, rebate documents. We had done one partial settlement and one manual approval. Okay, not one, two manual approvals we did. Okay. I want, see, others we hadn't carried out any correction or we hadn't carried out any final settlement. So those are grayed out. So let me choose the partial settlement. I can see that this is the document that is responsible for this activity. Okay. Now I want to close this rebate. In the rebate agreement we have seen, for the agreement status we must have set it to status B. So I am going to set it as rebate agreement is released for settlement. So save it. Okay, fine. Now I come back. Now I am going to execute the settlement. how much he has been. Out of 6,000, what he was given? 3,000 previously. Okay, so we have to add 3. Save it. System will create the final settlement request. So it is a credit memo. Okay, fine. For now, I go slash n VA02. Check credit memo. Save it. Settle it by billing VA01. Okay. What is the value of it? 3000 as the manual rebate. Let me go to the rebate now, slash NDB42 97. It is the rebate was already settled because you had carried out an settlement. Okay, so you can go and see what are all the relevant documents for this. We had a manual approval, we had a partial settlement, and we had a final settlement. Okay, so this is the rebate process in SD. Clear? Hello. Are you following it up or not? It's clear, okay. It becomes clear. Okay. Yeah. Okay. Okay, fine. Okay. That is why I always say, like, you carry out the assignments and you carry out of it, like, I can say Preeti is the best student of this lot. Because she regularly does the assignments and she comes up with the doubts, okay. Preeti is the best student of this batch. Okay. So that's the rebate process. Okay. Tomorrow we'll see about this contract. Okay. Yeah. Catch up tomorrow. Bye. No, new link I had.